To part two of my Cappuccino web application framework tutorial series. This tutorial I'll be showing you some basic UI connections, UI and code connections, so that includes outlets and actions. So if you're familiar with Coco, this will be pretty straightforward and easy for you. If you're not, it's still not that difficult, but you'll see how to do it within Cappuccino. And we're in Atlas here, so go ahead and open that up. It'll basically be just a simple Hello World application. I've dragged on a button to the window content area here. I put the text click me on there, which of course you don't have to do. You can change that text wherever you want. So if we just go down to the bottom right area of Atlas within the designer, the SIB designer area, and we have the button selected, you can see connections, and you'll see both outlets and actions. So outlets are basically ways to connect UI elements with variables, and then you can use those variables within your code. Actions are methods that are called onto your code coming from the UI. So actions are functions, outlets are just variables that you're connecting. So this button has a few default actions that I did not make, but like for example there's perform click, there's a whole bunch of stuff here. So let's go into our appcontroller.j and actually create an action. You do that by, it's just like creating a function within Cappuccino, which if you're not familiar with, it's exactly like Coco or Objective-C. So we have this dash here, and then in parentheses we say the data type that this method returns. In the case of actions, it doesn't actually have to return anything. It's just in this parentheses area we put at action. You'll see it in these other methods that really don't return anything. It's void. So if you're familiar with any other programming language, that'll make sense there. So we say at action, and then we have the name of the method. Let's call this button clicked, and then after the name of the method you can have like a colon there and actually have parameters that will be sent to that action when it's called. And in this case we can have an ID, a variable sender of type ID. There's the parentheses deal again, just saying what data type this is. We don't actually have to have an ID sender, but just for demonstration purposes we can do that. And then just as a test I'll say alert, you know, let's go and say alert sender, so that should show us like the data type of the sender and everything, which isn't overly helpful, but we get to, it's just a test. So now if we select app controller on the bottom area in Atlas, we should now see under connections and receive actions, we should see button clicked, and then it takes in an ID. So let's go ahead and try connecting this this button to that action. And you make connections in Atlas by holding down Alt and then clicking and dragging out. That'll bring out this like line deal, and you can actually bring that line to all these different elements. In this case, we want App Controller, and then when we release on App Controller, we should see this. Under received actions, we should see button clicked. So if you select button clicked, you can now see that we've made the connection and Atlas recognizes it. So let's go ahead and give that a try. And you can test your applications by doing build and run. I think by default it'll, okay, yeah. For some reason the Atlas debug mode doesn't work for Chrome browsers, so I'm just going to go ahead and put this in my Safari. So when I click the button, it actually shows in the alert box CP button and then all this other stuff. So we know that The sender is a CP button. Now I'm not sure, why this button is showing up like this. It may have been something I did earlier. Let me just try it out real quick. If you go into the size tab, you'll see this layout option. You can actually like change that. So this, I'm just gonna deselect everything except for the left side and the top like lines. So basically, those will change the how the button moves on the page as the window is moved. So let's go ahead and try that again. I'm just gonna build it so that okay, there we go. And then I'm gonna go back into Safari and refresh. And there's our button. It's proper now. So don't worry about what I just did. I had changed some things earlier, but it's not a big deal. So now if you click me, it'll show up with the alert box. So it's nice. Now let's test out an outlet. So outlets are just as easy or easier than making actions in Atlas. You just do under your at implementation, where all your other variables are defined, or your instance variables are defined, you can actually put Atlas or your outlets in there. Because all outlets are variables. So we're gonna say at outlet, it's of type CP button, right? So in Cappuccino, you define these IVARs with data types. So it's kind of like Objective-J is almost like a semi-hardly typed language, even though it's JavaScript. So at outlet CP button, because that's the type, the data type of this button, or this thing that we're connecting to this outlet, and then let's just call this like button. And then of course you have your semicolon, and this time within here, let's alert the button. So we should still see the same alert going on, it's just this time it's coming from an outlet rather than the actual sender parameter. So let's go ahead and try alt clicking and dragging out of click me and selecting app controller. Oh sorry, let's go the other way here. So alt click out of app controller and go into click me, and then see how this outlets thing pops up here. You can just select the button outlet. So save that, and I'm going to build it so I can just refresh in Safari. Close and refresh. So we should see the same alert, which we do. It's still of type CP button, so that tells me that our outlet was correctly connected. So that's just the basics of connections, outlets, and actions within Cappuccino and Atlas. It's very essential to know how to do those if you want to create nice UI through Atlas. So stay tuned for the next tutorial. We'll actually start getting deeper into writing Objective-J code, and we're going to do less of this UI or user interface stuff. Thanks for watching, and before I leave, if you haven't already gone there, my blog is connordenman.wordpress.com. I have other tutorials and various information stuff available here. So yeah, if you like my videos, please subscribe, like this video, comment, whatever. If you have questions, I usually answer. If you like comment it to me or send it or ask it on my blog, you can do any of that stuff. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next tutorial for Cappuccino and whatever else I may write tutorials for. See you next time.